My name is Rahul Panat, and I'm the Russell V. Trader Associate Professor of Mechanical Engineering at Carnegie Mellon University. I work on a project sponsored by Clarkson Aerospace and Air Force Office of Scientific Research, where we use 3D printing to create three-dimensional microstructures of atomically thin materials, that is, 2D nanomaterials. In the past, there was no way of stacking these 2D materials into three-dimensional space. However, a 3D printing technique developed in my lab, which uses fluid dynamics of micro droplets, enables us to do exactly that. Stacking of 2D materials in three-dimensional space enables us to use these materials for various electronic device applications. One of the important aspects of this grant is the involvement of Air Force, Navy, as well as Army cadets into this research project. We have two cadets working on this project at Carnegie Mellon University. In addition, we have a collaboration with Texas A&M International University, from where four cadets visited Carnegie Mellon University over the last few months in two separate visits. These cadets were exposed to various technologies, various projects going on at Carnegie Mellon, as well as specific research going on in my lab. These cadets visited the Manufacturing Futures Institute at MIL 19, where they were exposed to various aspects of digital transformation of manufacturing. They were also able to visit Advanced Robotics for Manufacturing facility to look at various robotics initiatives that are happening within the CMU ecosystem.
So far, the experience has been very amazing because I'm able to learn these skills that I could probably end up using in the far future, because I plan to go for my major in aerospace engineering later on after I'm done with my military career.
I have learned how to use several laboratory equipment such as the centrifuge that helps us to separate the supernatant and the precipitate. I am really excited to be working here and I hope to continue doing it. I want to keep gaining this valuable research experience and continue working in this field.
So far I've learned to synthesize materials to increase the stability of chemical structures to then be utilized as a heat-resistant building component for computer chips. Furthermore, I've grown in confidence and familiarity in working with extremely expensive equipment and tools.
Dr. Panat also took us on a tour of MIL 19, which houses the ARM Institute and MFI. We were shown various robotics projects and advanced engineering technologies. Overall, the visit was highly insightful and it showed me a taste of what performing research would be like as a career.
With the opportunity that we had working with Dr. Panat in Carnegie Mellon was once in a lifetime experience, because we have limited resources. The students having an exposure to these things that they would not have, I mean, opens a whole new horizon for them. When we came back from the trip in Pittsburgh, I could see the difference in their drive and their excitement, understanding the bigger picture of the work that we're doing.
I'm enjoying the opportunity to work with the cadets on the project, and through the research I've been training on various techniques: aerosol jet 3D printing, electrochemical impedance spectroscopy, and optical profilometry. I'm so grateful to Clarkson Aerospace for the opportunity to work on this project and to collaborate.
The knowledge the cadets have gained at Carnegie Mellon will be useful for them to get familiar with various modern technologies, especially in the electronics manufacturing area. And this can be useful in the field in many ways. In critical situations, for example, in a battlefield, if certain electronic component needs to be replaced or part needs to be manufactured, the cadets being familiar with 3D printing techniques can do on-site electronics repair or on-site 3D printing of critical parts, especially if they are not available because of the supply chain issues that we have seen recently. And this will give a very critical advantage to our armed forces compared to our competitors. Thank you.